Hi everyone, I'm Ibrahim Ulukaya from YouTube API Developer Relations team and joining you today from New York. Today we'll talk about a live streaming implementation called XSplit. And I'm sure if you guys are playing games and streaming them live, you're already familiar with this amazing product XSplit. But today we are really lucky to have Henrik Levering and Miguel Mano from XSplit to join us and talk about the product. Hi guys, thanks so much for joining us.
Good to be here. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
And today actually they'll talk about the product and hopefully we'll see like a nice live demo. But to start, can you talk about the history of the product and what are the goals behind this?
Yeah, definitely. Well, originally we XSplit Media Labs was really organized as a development team in a European a privately owned outsourcing company called World Partner. The team started off developing a set of multimedia applications for visual communication. And the app that we developed back then was called XSplit Capture. And that was really more of a like one to few communication video communication product. And that's the product based on which we got funding and created XSplit Media Labs as a company in Hong Kong back in 2009. This product was totally different from how XSplit Broadcaster is today. And basically, it evolved from XSplit Capture. XSplit Capture was only published in an internal beta. And from the feedback we got there and from the requirements we discovered from users and so forth, we sort of changed it from a simple screen capture with camera thing into a real internet TV application that we have today.
Okay, great. Can you just show us a little live demo of the product?
Absolutely, we can do that. So, I'll just boot up XSplit here, and some people might note that it doesn't exactly look like the XSplit that they know, and that's because the new version of XSplit that we're using here for this demo. So, for those who don't know XSplit, XSplit has 12 scenes that you can see here in the right corner, and we've got input sound and system sounds. I can drag, as you can see, an image to my first scene. And on my second scene, I'm going to add StarCraft 2, which I'm playing in the background here. So I've now got two scenes set up, and I'm ready to add my YouTube live channel. I just go to the broadcast menu, add the channel, and then I just fill in my credentials, Google YouTube credentials. And I need to authorize first using the OAuth2 and just typing in my password. So this all runs from Google servers and can take a little time, not because it's Google servers. We got authenticated. And we can add a description, title, and we can also set our category. These things we can change as we go live, but now we're done setting up the channel. So when we do go live now, you can see the title bar changes, and we get a prompt here. So we can now select whether we want to do an ad hoc event or connect to an existing scheduled event. We can also change our description, tags, and so forth, category, just before we go live. So consider the initial setup as a template, so to speak. So once we're live, then we've got a link in our clipboard, and we can try and test that out to see if we're live. And hopefully it's gonna show up in a short while. It can take a little time.
In the meantime, but, can you talk about like the new features in the new product? Maybe the I assume that you guys have like an upload feature as
actually,
well, right?
You can see as I was, some of the features in the new product is what we're seeing right here. Once we hover our mouse on top of the scenes, we can see a preview immediately, and that's definitely one of the new features. So anyway, now as you can see, we got live, and I'm just gonna stop this broadcast now. I'll just show you another new feature here, a very interesting thing, which is our feature that allows XSplit to upload videos and track videos straightly on YouTube. So as you can see here, the preview, that's one of the features. We're hovering our mouse across the scenes and we can see the preview. We can see what's behind the scene, basically. Right now you can see on scene 2, my StackRaft was there. Right, so that's one of the things. It's a brilliant thing with the new version of the product. So now I've made a small recording, and I can then go to my recordings, where I can see the recording I just made. I can change the thumbnail view. So this recording I can share it on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. But first, I need to share it on YouTube. I need to upload it to YouTube. And I can set my title and my privacy settings there, and I can straightly go and upload it. That also could take a few seconds, but our video is not that big, so that should be up in a few seconds. Yeah, we have to have a little patience, perhaps. So anyway, once it's up, we can see it here. It has a link, and we can just check it out to see that it actually got uploaded. Well, it's being processed, but it's certainly, yeah. We'll just it'll just take a minute. It's there already, I think. Yep. So that's the video we just recorded a few minutes ago.
That's great.
So as you can see, there's a small, you can see a little red thing in the video before, and that was what that was uploaded to YouTube. Now we're sharing it on Facebook, and we can share it on Twitter as well. And so these sharing features, and certainly also, yeah, Google+. And these sharing features all requires that it's uploaded to YouTube first.
Nice.
So yeah, we track the videos there. So next time you open XSplit, you can see what videos in my video recordings that was actually that's already on YouTube.
Sounds great. And thanks for this amazing demo. Can you just talk a little bit about how this app implemented? What programming languages did you use?
Yeah, certainly. So all our core is built in C++, because we have a lot of functions that are very close to the operating system. So that's sort of what we found most suitable. And the UI and other functions, such as, for example, the YouTube live broadcast plugin, is built using C#.
Was there any reason that you guys used C#?
Well, it's a pretty... And a lot of people know C#, and it's easier usually to develop interface using C#. So I think that's why we originally chose C#.
Okay. Maybe we got to talk about if you guys use our APIs through the client libraries or just like straight to the calls.
Okay, well, I think I can answer that.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Initially, we were trying to implement it in C++, but since when we started our implementation, the live API was very much in beta, and a lot of things were changing. So it was highly impractical for us to keep rewriting our REST code in C++. So we just settled for the C# client library that's provided by you guys.
Yeah, I should mention that you guys were one of the first implementers first using the beta version as well. And by using that, can you also talk about if you're using the other APIs besides the live streaming? Because I saw you were doing uploads and you were also tracking the videos.
Yes, we're actually using the data API, both version 2 and version 3. We mainly use the version 3 API, but for tracking our videos, such as tagging it with developer tags, we have to use the version 2 data API because that's the only library that supports developer tags. But we do hope that you will support developer tags in the newer version.
Yeah, there's definitely a request on that, and we hope to have the developer tax on B3 as well. And besides that, can you guys share any other feedbacks, or were you guys have any like surprise moments when you were implementing this API?
Well, back when we started, we were actually surprised that there was no live viewer count. That was, I think, early this year. But it's already implemented now in your latest release, so peace be with that. And we were also surprised with the way broadcasts and streams were like kind of different, because in our other use cases, we just kind of stream straight to an endpoint and that's it. They have one endpoint and then we take note of that and we stream to it. But in your API, there you create multiple stream objects and then you bind them to broadcast objects, which are the actual events. And from what I understand is the stream objects, so that the endpoints can be reusable and the settings are very much preset. So you can just select which particular broadcast resolution you're going to be going for and then just bind it to an event. I think that's how you wanted it.
Yeah, definitely. You summarized for me already. And are there any like features or do you guys want us to pursue or prioritize?
Currently, I guess we would like to enable our broadcasters to be able to interact with the users more, with the viewers more. And to do that, we need some sort of implementation for your live comments. But we also noticed the big delay from the real-time broadcast to the actual thing that you see on YouTube. So there's like a 40-45 second delay, and that would probably kill any sort of real-time interaction between users and viewers and broadcasters.
Yeah, I think it's right. I mean, the big missing feature right now is really low latency and then real-time comments.
Yes.
We see a lot of the big streams in gaming where really the broadcaster feeds off the user's comments. Do this, go there, and they really have a wonderful interaction there. And so we'd love to see that on YouTube Live as well. That's the biggest missing feature, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah, thanks for the valuable feedback. I'm sure actually we are like really doing like our best to get like latency lowest as possible, and hopefully we'll have comments in future. And maybe like to summarize, I heard actually you guys also have like opportunities in XSplit as well. Can you guys talk a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. So we're definitely also hiring in XSplit. You can go to xsplit.com/careers. And I think we have positions open both for like C++ developers, C# developers, web developers, and so forth. And our development center is located in Manila. But we're certainly also accepting applications from developers from other countries, US and so forth. So yeah, that'd be great. Go to xsplit.com/careers and see if there might be a position you guys would like to apply for.
Okay. Thanks so much for joining me today, guys. That was like really nice to see the live demo and talk about the XSplit product. And we really like hope to like see like the new features and the new version publicly available really soon.
That was great to be here, Ibrahim. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
Thanks a lot. And lastly, I actually want to like finish up with saying that we also, as a Google Developer Relations team, we are hiring almost everywhere in the world. You can always like check the options from developer.google.com/jobs. And thanks for joining me today, guys. And have a nice day. Ibrahim Ulukaya from New York.